Hello, the name of the problem is Design Tic-Tac-Toe. This problem is very famous among companies such as Microsoft, Apple, Facebook and Amazon. So now let us read the problem statement. The problem statement says that design a tic-tac-toe game that is played between two players on an n by n grid. And the following rules are there. So a move is guaranteed to be valid and is placed on an empty block. Once the winning condition is reached, no more move is allowed. A player who succeeds in placing n of their marks in horizontal or vertical or diagonal row wins the game. So what is a tic-tac-toe? So in a tic-tac-toe, we are given n by n grid. Suppose n is 3 in this case. So we will be given a square grid of size n by n, that is 3 by 3. In this game, there are two players, player 1 and player 2. Now, suppose the symbol for player 1 is 0 and symbol for player 2 is x. So, player 1, if it starts the game, it can mark anywhere on the grid. Suppose it marks it on 0 by 0 cell. Now it is player 2's turn, and player 2 can mark anywhere except this position. So suppose let's say it marks here. Now again it is player 1's turn. Player 1 will mark, let's say, on this cell. Now player 2 can mark anywhere on the cell which are empty. So let's say player 2 marks it here. Now it is again player 1's turn. Player 1 will mark here. Now player 1 succeeds in making n consecutive cells with a symbol O in diagonal wise. So the three conditions to win the game is either you have to make n consecutive symbols diagonally, or you have to make it horizontally, or you have to make it vertically. In this case, player 1 succeeds in making his symbol, that's O, in a left, in the top to bottom and left to right diagonal. So player 1 wins the game. Another possibility could be, let's say player 2, instead of marking here, he marked it here. Now it is player 1's turn again, so player 1 marks here. Now it is player 2's turn, so player 2 mark it here. Now player 1 can mark either here or here, and he will win the game because there will be n consecutive symbols in either this column wise or row wise. So this is what a tic-tac-toe game is. Now we have to implement this game. In this game, we get n as the initializer. Then in moves, we will be given certain number of moves. So each move will contain player, that is player ID, whether it is the player 1 whose turn is this, or player 2 whose turn is this. Then we will be given row and column, that is the cell on which this player is marking. Now we have to return either 0. 0 means that it is none of them wins the game in this particular move. That is, neither player 1 nor player 2 wins the game in this particular move. So for example, when we were doing something here, so in each turn, in the first turn, no one wins the game. In the second turn also, no one wins the game. So we have to return, we have to keep returning 0 in those moves. As soon as any of the player wins the game, we have to return the ID of that player. So one possible implementation of this game could be, we can have a n by n character grid like this. And then we will keep marking on each move the cell on which that player is going to mark. So we will keep marking that in the fashion that we were discussing the example. And at the same time, after marking, we will check whether this player is winning or not. So that checking could be done in O of n square if we are going to look in the entire grid. Or that checking could be slightly optimized in O of n. So how that could be done is... Now suppose it is player 2's turn. So player 2 marks it here. Okay. So when he marks at this position, what could be the possibility? The possibility could be he can either win this in a column wise manner or in a row wise manner. So we will only check this row and this column. So checking of this row and this column will take off n time. Now suppose the player 2 marks here. Now here we will have to check it in this row, in this column, as well as diagonally. So what are the conditions to check diagonally? For this diagonal, the condition is I should be equals to j, that is row should be equals to column. Then we will be checking this diagonal as well with the row and the column. Now what are the condition for this diagonal? So for this diagonal, the condition is I plus j should be equals to n minus 1, that is row plus column should be equals to n minus 1, where n is the size of the grid. So this is the condition for this right to left column, and this is the condition for left to right column. So if these condition arises, we will have to check for the entire column as well as the row and the column. Now this implementation is big O of n square in terms of space and big O of n in terms of time. This time is for each particular move. So each particular move will take big O of n here. Now can we have a slightly optimized approach? So the answer is yes. Now instead of making the entire matrix and checking it again and again, what we can do is, now let's say this is our matrix. We are not going to create the entire matrix in our memory. We will just have a virtual picture of this. So let's say this is 0, 1 and 2. These are the columns. And these are the rows 0, 1 and 2. Now, for a player to win in a row-wise manner, it should have entire cells, entire column of this row marked with his symbol. For example, if he is going to win in this particular row, so these all should be marked with his symbol. And if he is going to win in this particular row, so all these columns should be marked with his symbol. So what we can do is, we can create an array. This is for 0th row, this is for 1st row, this is for 2nd row. Now as soon as a player marks on, let's say, row and column, on this cell, I comma jth cell, which is row and column, so we are going to increment this row. Let's say he marks on the first row and second column. So the first row is this, second column is this. If he marks it here, what we will do is we'll increment this. So we will make it 1. So this is 0, this is 0. We will make it 1. Now let me make a similar kind of array for columns as well. So the 0th column, 1st column and the 2nd column. So he marks at the cell 1, 2. So 1, 2 means on the 2nd column. So here we will increment this to 1. This is 0, this is 0. Okay. Now, if a player wants to win in this particular column, let's say column number 2, the value here should be 3. And if he wants to win in this particular row, the value here should be 3. So in each move, we will be incrementing that particular row and particular column. So now we will try to implement it on an example. So this was the move of player 1. Now let's say player 2 marks it here. Now what player 2 did is, he marked on row 1 and column 0. So this is a row 1. Now we will have to decrement this because player 1 has marked here. So this will again become 0. And this will become minus 1. Now let's say again, player 1, let's say he marks here. So he marks on the 0th row and 2nd column. So 2nd column will be incremented. Now there are 2 such symbols in the row number 2. So it will be 2 here. And he marked it on the 0th row. So here it will be 1. Here it will be, instead of 0, it will be 1 here. Now it is player 2's turn and he marks, let's say here. So now he marks on 1 by 1. In 1 it will become minus 1 and here in 1 it will again become minus 1. Now let's say the player 2, he marks here. Now in the column 2, the entry will become 3. So now as soon as we get this entry equals to 3, that is the size of the grid, we will return that the player 1 wins the game. So instead of using n square space, we are only using O of n space here. That's the first thing to be noticed. And instead of checking the entire row and the entire column on which we are marking, we are just checking that the value at the current row and the current column, whether or not it becomes equals to the size of the array or not. So this is big O of 1. Just checking a particular cell. Now we will handle the cases of diagonal. So when we are given that row is equals to column, we will increment the diagonal. So diagonals will be a variable because there are only two diagonals, so there will be two variables, one for diagonal from the left to right and one for the diagonals from right to left. So whenever player 1 moves in such a way that row plus row is equals to column, it is basically marking somewhere on this diagonal. So we will increment this diagonal. And when the player 1 is marking in such a way that the sum of row and column is equals to n minus 1, it is basically marking somewhere over this diagonal. So we will increment this in that case. Now when player 2 is moving, making a move on this diagonal, we will decrement this diagonal. Similarly, if the player 2 is making a move on this diagonal, we will decrement this diagonal. So once player 2 basically moves anywhere, okay, one more thing to be noticed is we are assigning these negative values for player 2. So sometimes it might happen that this value becomes minus 3. This value becomes minus 3. Then it is player 2 who wins the game, because it is player 2 who entirely covers this particular column. Or if it becomes minus 3, it is player 2 who entirely covers the row number 0. So we will have to keep check of both the values, positive 3 and negative 3. Similarly, in the case of diagonals also, we will have to check whether the diagonal becomes a positive 3 or negative 3. So if it is negative 3, it is player 2's turn, it is player 2's win, and if it is 3, then it is player 1's win. So now we will try to implement this. We will try to code this problem. I will directly go for the best approach, which was big O of 1 in terms of time. So basically we will have to keep one array for row and one for column. Then this is D1, diagonal 1. Diagonal 1 will be from left to right, and diagonal 2, this will be from right to left. Also, we'll have to keep N. Let's make it S. So S is equals to N here. R is equals to, we are going to dynamically make this array of size N. And column is equals to new int of size N. D1 is equals to D2 is equals to 0. Min set R comma 0 comma size of R. Min set C comma 0 comma size of C. If the current player, if the current player is equals to 1, we are going to increment. So R of row plus plus and C of column plus plus. If row is equals to column, in this case we are on the left right diagonal, so D1 plus plus. If row plus column is equals to N minus 1, in this case D2 plus plus. Now if this row or this column is equals to N, is equals to N, or this D1 is equals to N, or this D2 is equals to N, in this case we have the player 1 wins the game, so return player 1, else return 0, that is none of them is winning the game in this particular move. Now we will do a similar kind of thing for player 2. Now this is, in this else, it is player 2 who's going to make his move. So instead of incrementing, we will be decrementing in this move. So if it is equals to negative of n, negative n, negative n. So now player 2 wins the game. Let us try to debug this. N is not there. Okay, so basically globally we initialized it with S. Okay, we'll have to use S everywhere. Was not again line number 39 again. I think the problem is with the initialization. Here we have to initialize the array with 0. Let us try to submit this. Okay. So it is working fine. So space complexity, as we discussed, is O(n), and the time complexity is O(1) for each particular move.